Szanowni Państwo, drodzy uczniowie, nauczyciele, rodzice, przyjaciele Muracza, cały rok, praktycznie niemal cały rok spotykania się, ćwiczenia, ponaglania siebie nawzajem, wysłuchiwania, próbowania. No i wreszcie nastał ten moment, kiedy The Morach English Theatre zaprezentuje swoje show pod tytułem
Beauty and the Beast. W imieniu swoim oraz członków naszego teatru chciałabym powitać Was wszystkich na czwartym już spektaklu w naszym wykonaniu. Zapewne część z Was pamięta spektakl Frozen, który w zeszłym roku szkolnym wystawialiśmy dwa razy, ale pewnie nieliczni tylko pamiętają pierwszą sztukę, od której zaczęła się przygoda z teatrem w Moraczu, czyli opowieść wigilijną. Wtedy tę opowieść wigilijną wystawiło tylko kilkunastu uczniów jednej klasy. Natomiast teraz w skład naszego teatru wchodzą uczniowie z przeróżnych klas, z całej szkoły podstawowej oraz gimnazjum przy Żeromskiego. Nasi aktorzy podjęli się nie lada wyzwania, ponieważ za chwilę zaprezentują Wam sztukę w całości w języku angielskim. Jest to właśnie efekt naszej prawie rocznej pracy, podczas której nasi uczniowie uczyli się także pod okiem profesjonalnych aktorów. Słuchajcie, za tą kurtyną czeka na Was aż 37 wspaniałych aktorów, muzyków, tancerzy oraz też niewidocznych na scenie, ale równie niezastąpionych członków naszej ekipy. I razem z nimi za chwilę przeniesiemy się do małej wioski w XVIII-wiecznej Francji, aby doświadczyć tego, jak dzięki potędze miłości niemożliwe staje się możliwe. Zapraszamy Was na spektakl Beauty and the Beast. Rozumiem, że ten nasz wstęp jeszcze Was nie pobudził do oklasków, ale zachęcamy do spontanicznego wyrażania swojego entuzjazmu, tak? Podczas przedstawienia. Przywitajmy oklaskami Morach English Theatre.
Once upon a time in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish and unkind.
But then, one winter night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be devised by appearance, for beauty is found within.
And when he reminded her again, an old woman's ugliness melted away and revealed a beautiful enchantress.
The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. And as punishment, transformed a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there.
Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle and with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world.
The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years.
If he can learn to love another and earn her love in return, by the time the last petal fell, the spell would be broken.
If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time.
As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope.
For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Every day, like the one before. little town full of little people waking up to the same old bread and rolls to sell. Every morning just the same, since the morning that we came to this poor provincial town.
Good morning, Belle.
Good morning.
And where are you going off to today?
The bookshop. I just finished the most wonderful story about a beanstalk and an ogre and a...
That's nice. Marie, the baguettes, hurry up.
Look, there she goes, that girl is strange, no question. Dazed and distracted, can you tell? Never part of any crowd, cause her head is up on so loud. No way, she's a funny girl.
I've come to return the book I borrowed.
Finished it already?
Oh, I couldn't put it down. Have you got anything new?
Not since yesterday.
That's all right. I'll borrow this one.
That one? But you'll read it twice.
Well, it's my favorite.
If you like it all that much, it's yours.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Look, there she goes, that girl is so peculiar. I wonder if she's feeling well. Her dreamy first look, and her nose stuck in a book. What a puzzle to the rest of us is there.
Oh, isn't this amazing? It's my favorite part, because you'll see. Chapter 3.
Now it's no wonder that her name is Beauty. Her looks have got no parallel. But behind that fair facade, I'm afraid she's rather odd. Very different from the rest of us. She's nothing like the rest of us.
You didn't miss a shot, Gaston. You're the greatest hunter in the whole world.
I know.
No beast alive stands chance against you. And no girl, for that matter.
It's dreadful, and I've got my sight on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
She's lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's...
the most beautiful girl in the town.
I know, but...
and don't I deserve best?
Of course you do.
Mary Bell. There he goes, he's a dreamy, and
Bonjour, Gaston. Gaston, may I have my book, please?
How can you even read that? There's no pictures.
Well, some people use their imagination.
Well, it's about time you get your head off these books and pay attention to more important things.
Hint.
Like you? Oh, Gaston, please. I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yes, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius.
I'll never get this bonehead collection to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win the first prize at the fair tomorrow.
So let's get cracking. Well, let me see. Where did I put my dog the clencher?
Here you go, Papa.
Thank you, dear. So have you got a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Papa, do you think I'm odd?
My daughter odd? Where did you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just, I'm not so sure I fit in here. There's no one I can really talk to.
What about Gaston? He's a handsome fellow.
He's handsome, all right. And rude, and conceited, and... Oh, Papa, he's just not for me.
Well, don't you worry, because this invention is gonna be a start of new life for us. So what do you say we give her a try?
All right. It works!
It does? It does!
Papa, you did it! You really did it! I made a scarf for you, for a good luck.
Now I know I'll win the first prize at the fair tomorrow, and then we'll travel to other places you've read in your books.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye.
Be careful!
That, but I lost my way in the woods and I was looking for a place to stay for the night.
If we keep quiet, maybe he will go away.
Wait, you're like talk, and you're talking.
Sir, stop it!
I don't mean to enter that, but I never see you talking.
You're chilled to the bone, Monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
Not the master's chair! I'm not seeing this!
Ooh la la! What have we here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man?
All right, this has gone far enough!
Oh, yes, please.
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hey there, little fella. What's your name?
Chip.
We've got to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we're a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know. Or maybe he will?
There's a stranger here.
Master, allow me to explain.
Who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say I was against him from the start?
You all betrayed me. Who are you?
My money.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You are not welcome here.
Then I will be on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it? You've came here to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I will give you a place to stay.
No, please, no.
To the bride.
Hi, Belle. Have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him. Wait a minute. Where did you get that scarf?
This? In the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father. Oh no, something must have happened to him.
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
Oh no, Papa!
Nie ma czasu.
Keep quiet!
just had to invite him to stay?
I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish!
Oh, Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what's left of our humanity? Look at us. Look at you.
What about me? Oh, right.
If the master doesn't break the spell, slowly but surely we'll all become things.
Hold on, old man, we've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl. This is the one. The girl you have been waiting for. She has come to break the spell.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let's not be hasty.
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Belle, is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me?
Your hands are like ice. Who's done this to you?
There's still no time to explain. You must go, now.
No, I won't let you leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone. Get out!
Wait, please. Forgive me. Please let him out. Can't you see he's not well?
Then he should have not trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
There is nothing you can do.
Wait, please. Take me instead.
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes, but you must promise to stay here forever.
No.
Come into the light.
Well, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done. Go back to the village.
Wait! No! Not yet!
Belle.
Papa! You didn't let me say goodbye.
Master, since the girl is going to be with us for quite some time, you must offer her a more comfortable room.
I will show it your room. You, follow me. This is your home. You are free to go anywhere you like, except the West Wing.
Why?
What's it's that? Forbidden! You are never to set foot in there. Do you understand?
Yes.
This is your room. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for the dinner. That is not a request!
Choice for Papa, I will stay, but I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way. You monster.
of the top provincial town. Is this home? Am I here for a day or forever? Shut away from the world until who knows when? Oh, but then, as my life has been altered, change again. The entire walls around me change every lock and key. Nothing lasts, nothing holds all of me. My heart's far, far away.
But you are...
Mrs. Potts, dearie, please make your acquaintance. What shall we dress for dinner? Let's see what I've got in the drawers.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to the dinner.
Of course you are. You heard what Master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. Oh, I'm sorry. This is just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm going to miss my papa so much.
I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then well, it's you. And who knows, you may find home here too.
You've got to pull yourself together. Gosh, is this test me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dump. Every guy here loves to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You everyone's favorite guy. No one's quick as Gaston. No one's know us incredibly fixed, Gaston. But it's no ask any Tom, Dick or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. Who plays stars like Gaston? Who break hearts like Gaston? Who's much more of the sum of his parts like Gaston? Now one fights like Gaston, does a slice like Gaston. In a breasty match, nobody bites like Gaston.
I'm especially good and expectorating.
It's Dutch fur.
I don't care.
Now one fights like Gaston, matches with like Gaston. In a speeding match, nobody spies like Gaston.
Unexpectorating.
10 points for Gaston!
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. Now I'm grown up, I ate 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size.
For dinner, where is she? Perhaps I should see about her. Won't be a minute.
tried to be penitent, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I am not a fool.
Good, so you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken, we'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time, the rose has already begun to wilt.
It's not use, she's so beautiful, I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Master, you must help her to see past all that.
I don't know how.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all...
What?
You must control your temper.
Well, where is she?
She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, your grace, let's not be hasty.
I told you to come to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle and I'm telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you, I'm not hungry.
Master, that may be not the best way to win the girl's affection.
Please attempt to be a gentleman.
Deep breaths, master. Deep breaths.
I will give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please?
No, thank you.
Fine, then starve.
Master, please.
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again.
What you two led us to do? Give up? I like this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she's just being stubborn. After all, he said please.
I think it was the first time I heard him using that word. Hello, dearie. I hope Master didn't threaten you too much. He is a little temperamental.
A little?
I'm Cogsworth, the head of the household. And this is Lumiere.
Enchanté, mademoiselle.
If there is anything we can do to make you stay more comfortable, anything at all.
Well, I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, Pistosh, I'm not about to let this poor child go hungry.
All right. Crust of bread, glass of water, and then...
Cogsworth, she's not a prisoner. She's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right. Dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it will be our next.
Of course. But what's the dinner without a little music?
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as a dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, put out service to the test, tie your napkin round your neck, sherry, and we'll provide the rest. Soup du jour, hors d'oeuvre, why we only live to serve. Try the grey stuff,
it's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes, they can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is fast. The dinner here is never second best. Go on and call your menu, cake and glass, and then you'll be our guest, we are guests. Be our guest.
With ragout, cheese soufflé,
pie and pudding en flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one gloomy or complaining. Why the blood was and then tell me.
We can draw
and do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all the perfect day that you can have.
Come on and lift your glass, you want your own free pass. Our guest, if
feel stressed, it's fine dining, we suggest. Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Life is so unnerving for the servant who's not serving. He's not home without a soul to wait upon. Oh, those good old days when we was full. Suddenly those good old days are gone.
Too long we've been dusting, needing so much more than dusting, needing exercise to chance to use our skills.
Most days we just lay around the castle.
Flabby, flat and lazy, yoked in the oopsie-daisy.
It's a guest, stakes a level, I confess. While the fair, the lord, after nothing's freshly pressed.
Read the salt, she won't sleep, and my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups of days of chewing, she be bubbling, she be brewing.
I get warm, I be cold, heaven takes not a spot. Clean in the cold, the company impressed. We've got a lot to do, it's a
everyone. Good show. Well done. Oh my goodness. Look at the time. Off to bed.
Oh, I couldn't possibly go to bed now. It's my first time in an enchanted castle.
Perhaps you would like a tour.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm not sure that's such a good idea.
Perhaps you would like to take me. I'm sure you know everything there is to know about the castle.
Well, actually, I do.
Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. This will be good.
And this is yet another example of late neoclassic Baroque period. And, as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it! May I draw your attention to the flying buttresses above the aviary?
Oh, Lumiere. It's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman? I am nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking of my part, the disaster was averted.
What's up there?
Nothing. Nothing at all interesting in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
Perhaps, mademoiselle, would you like to see something else? We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back.
Don't touch that!
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here? I told you never to come here.
I know, but...
Do you realize what you could have done? Get out!
No! Don't touch me!
No, I...
Promise or no promise, I won't stay here!
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to frighten you. You don't understand, there is so little left of me. So little left.
Oh,
Belle ran away from the castle as fast as she could.
Night was falling, the storm was approaching, but it was getting hard to see.
When she stopped to catch her breath, Belle heard growls of wolves.
The beast now lay wounded on the ground and she couldn't leave him.
He ran to his side and helped him up.
Then the bell and the beast slowly made their way to the castle.
If you'd hold still, it wouldn't hurt as much.
If you hadn't run away, this wouldn't have happened.
If you hadn't frightened me, I wouldn't have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have been in a West Wing.
And you should learn to control your temper. Just hold still. It may sting. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
That's more like that. I knew they can go ahead if they tried.
So the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon either. The rose is losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention the fact that I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give them a little push.
I forgot just a thing. How about warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was cursed and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
Cheers! Come along, Mary. Let's put you off those wet things.
She goes this way, I thought I saw. And when we touched it, didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can be, I'll just ignore. But I should never look at me that way before.
I want to give her something. Something that sparks her interest.
Who's back?
Say something about the hair.
It's brown.
A compliment.
What a nice bow.
Thank you.
Together on their own,
so peculiar,
we wait and see.
We're
do they swore? There may be something that there wasn't there before.
Perhaps there's something that there wasn't there before.
What?
There may be something there that wasn't there before.
What's there, Mama?
Shh, I tell you when you are older.
And then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword and...
So that must mean he's a king!
Wait and see.
I never knew books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from this place, make me forget for a little.
Forget?
About who, about what I am.
We have something in common, you know.
We do?
In the town where I came from, people think I'm odd.
You?
So, I know how it is to feel different and how lonely that can be.
Inside, I want. I can't.
Haha, we, my little friend. The day you have been waiting for may be at hand.
Human again.
Human again. Think of what that means. I'll be cooking again, be good looking again, with a mademoiselle on each arm. When I'm human again, only human again, poisoned, polished and gleaming with charm. I'll be courting again, chicken sporting again,
which will cause several husbands alarm.
And to sweet be myself,
of no shame.
Human again.
When we're human again, only human again. Where we keep constant what's not so hard. Actually, I'm only too sure. Other lips you can rush, and I won't be so huge. I can see through that door. I could love her, I can't have her. It's my part to be human.
Sit back sipping tea, let my early retirement commence. Far from home, I relax in town to break decks and relax when I'm human again.
When Guinevere heard that Arthur was slain, she went away to a convent and no one could ever smile her again.
What a beautiful story.
And you like it. I'd like to ask you something.
What's that?
A second chance. Would you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? With you? Well, that would be... I mean... Oh, yes!
I don't usually leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but this fellow said you'd make it worth my while.
I promised myself I'd be married to Belle, but
I don't think I can do this.
You must.
How will I know when the moment is right?
You will know it because you will feel it here, and you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from... I can't.
You must! What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid she might what? Love for me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left. I really don't think I can do this.
You can do it, master. I know you can.
See him again.
There is a way. This mirror will show you anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father. Papa! Oh no, Papa! Something's wrong. He's in the woods. I think he's lost. I should...
Go.
What?
You should go to him.
But what about...
You are not a prisoner anymore. You haven't been for a long time. Keep it. So you'll always have a way to look back and remember me.
I could never forget you.
Belle.
Yes?
Belle, I... Go. 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 I will never see her again. Well, sir, I must say, everything is going just swimmingly. I know you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
How could you do that?
I had to.
But why?
After all this time, he finally learned to love.
That's it then. That should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
And now it's too late.
Of my fate, I never needed anybody in my life. I learned the truth too late. I'll never shake away the pain. I close my eyes, but she's still there. I let her steal into my melancholy heart. It's more than I can bear. Even as she runs away, she will still torment me, call me, hurt me, move me, come what may. Wasting in my lonely tower, waiting by an open door. I fool myself, she walk right in. And be with me forevermore. I rage against the trials of love. I curse the setting of the light. Though she's already gone so far beyond my reach, she's never out of sight. Tower, waiting by an open door. I fool myself, she walk right in. And there's a long, long night's begin. I think of all that I have been waiting here forever.
I'd never find you.
But the beast, how did you escape?
I didn't escape. He let me go.
He let you go? That terrible beast?
He's not terrible. In the beginning, I was so frightened. I thought it was the end of everything, but
somehow things changed.
Good afternoon.
Monsieur Dark.
I can talk like to your father.
What?
Don't worry.
My father is not crazy.
He was raving like a lunatic. We all heard him, didn't we?
Yes.
Poor Belle. It's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know he's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up the misunderstanding if...
If what?
If you'll marry me.
What?
That's all it takes.
Never.
Have it your way. Take the old man.
No, wait! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him.
Oh no. I know he looks frightful, but he's really kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I didn't know you better, I would say feelings for that monster.
He's not monster, Gaston. You are.
She's crazy as the old man. She's saying that creature is her friend. I've hunted beasts like this before. I've seen what they can do. The beast will make off with your children. He'll come after them in the night.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I said, we kill the beast.
Shh.
beast. Bell is mine.
No!
Bell, it has to be done.
Maybe it's better that way.
We are home. We are where we shall be forever. Trust in me, for you know I won't run away. From today, that is all that I need. And all that I need to say.
Just a little change. Small to say the least, both a little scared. Neither one prefer beauty and the beast. Every child's the same. Every is surprise. Every is before. Every just as sure as the sun will
Kuba Sekuła. W roli wieśniaczek Ania Kosicka, Tosia Tokarczyk. Głupiutkie panny Karolina Krasowska, Kamila Błażejczyk, Zosia Tokarczyk, Józia Szarczewska, Marcysia Wojtaszczyk. Marysia Gabryś, Zosia Michalak, Tosia Tokarczyk, Zosia Tokarczyk, Kamila Błażejczyk, Józia Szarczewska, Karolina Krasowska. Wilki, Zosia Skubi, Kuba Sekuła, Józia Szarczewska i Tosia Tokarczyk. Pytam, Pania Olejnik. Woo!
Julia Kulicka. Narratorki Paulina Grymuza, Marcysia Wojtaszczyk, Ania Kosicka. Wróżka Zosia Tokarczyk. Monsieur Dark Kamil Ptaszek. Mrs. Fox Kosia Szarszewska, Chip Jagoda Woźniczka. Babeczka Karolina Krasowska, Lumier Łucja Wróblewska i Cogsworth Patrycja Piętowska. Ojciec Belli, Old Maurice, Szymek Tokarczyk. O, przepraszam, Tomczuk. Lefu, Hania Olejnik oraz Gaston, Kosia Małek. W roli bestii, Tola Bogula. W roli księcia Kuba Mielczarek. W roli Belli Alicja Rudowicz. Ktoś czeka w mikrofon. W skład zespołu weszły niezastąpione dzieci naszego pana dyrektora Róża, Boguś i Sławek Abramowicz. Podwójna aranżacja utworu Beauty and the Beast, przygotowanie tego zespołu oraz pomoc w nagłośnieniu, w obsłudze świateł, to był nasz pan od muzyki, pan Szymon Stateczny. No jest. Zapraszamy na scenę. Ekipa naszych niewidocznych, ale niezastąpionych inspicjentów. Marta Maczuga, Agata Pajchel, Karolina Pajchel, Marysia Cherubin, Michał Wiśniewski, Łukasz Kowalski, Kuba Kajkowski. Agata Pajchel, jeszcze fryzury z Karoliną Pajchel. Karolina jest? Dalej, słuchajcie, osoba, bez której nie odbyłaby się większość prób, odpowiedzialny za całą ścieżkę dźwiękową, za nagłośnienie, za oświetlenie, filar tej sztuki, Maciej Brzemiński. Słuchajcie, koordynację prac nad wykonaniem tych pięknych kostiumów, sprzętów zamkowych sprawowała pani od plastyki, pani Michalina Moro. Zapraszamy tutaj na scenę. Zapraszamy, Michalinka. Tam macha do wszystkich. Proszę się tam odwrócić. Przygotowanie kostiumów, rekwizytów, charakteryzacja oraz fryzury. Trzy niezastąpione mamy. Pani Agnieszka Małek, pani Vanessa Tomczuk oraz pani Katarzyna Tokarczyk. Zapraszamy. Wielkie, wielkie brawa. Panie Agnieszko, zapraszamy. Transport i montaż scenografii. Pan Wojtek Skowron. Panie Wojtku, pan pomacha chociaż. Pomoc graficzna, medialna, techniczna, gdzieś pewnie tutaj krążący pan Benjamin Kalisz. Także nasz spektakl
nagrywał, też nie widzę zupełnie, ale pan Szymon Honciak z ekipą, to jakbyście pomagali do nas. O, proszę, pan Jelko, chyba jakiś. Chcielibyśmy jeszcze bardzo podziękować całej ekipie tutaj, muszę przeczytać tę nazwę. To jest dowództwo jednostki wojskowej 1. Warszawskiej Brygady Pancernej. Panu pułkownikowi Janowi Wojno oraz panu majorowi Tomaszowi Kluskowskiemu za użyczenie nam tej pięknej, pięknej sali. Dziękujemy też pani Karolinie Waszczyńskiej, nie wiem, czy tutaj obecnej, za pożyczliwość, za pomoc tutaj w próbach. Oraz dziękujemy też panu, który jest z tyłu i wszystko nam tutaj wyświetlał, nagłaśniał. Wiele godzin spędził z nami na próbach. Panu Wiesławowi Siekierce. Brawa do tyłu. I na koniec też chcieliśmy bardzo podziękować panu dyrektorowi, panu Arturowi, za to, że już kolejny raz umożliwił nam cały rok pracy, rozwijania tych talentów, spełniania marzeń. Panie Arturze, dziękujemy też za wsparcie w trudnych chwilach, które mieliśmy niejednokrotnie, za to, że pan wierzył w nas, nie zrezygnował, przyjmuje nas takim, jakim jesteśmy, z tym występem, takim, jakim jest. Przecież jest super.
Pani Marta.
Myślę, że to, co pani robi, to czyni pani tą szkołę piękniejszym miejscem, jeszcze piękniejszym, że to jest pięknym miejscem, nie tylko się uczymy, ale przeżywamy takie super wydarzenia, które pozostają w naszych sercach, nas, rodziców, też jestem rodzicem, wykonawcą tutaj, poza tym, że jestem dyrektorem i producentem. W naszych sercach nas, rodziców, gdzie są rodzice, nauczyciele, nauczycieli w sercach, nauczycieli pozostałych. Także, pani Marto, cokolwiek pani wymyśli, biorę wszystkich na świadków, cokolwiek pani wymyśli, jakikolwiek budżet pani skonstruuje, z gwiazdką powstanie, to jest to wielki honor i przyjemność przybył dla mnie z panem.
Którzy gdzieś na lekcjach plastyki dorabiali stroje. Bardzo wam wszystkim dziękujemy i na koniec chcieliśmy też, chodźcie tu do przodu, podziękować państwu za to, że państwo jesteście z nami, wszystkim uczniom Moracza, bo bez widowni ten nasz spektakl też byłby bez sensu. Także brawa dla was od nas. Kolejnym spektaklu.
Small to say the least.